Looking for a start as Eddie Wirth will bring him out of turn number four. The green is out. We are back to racing speed. Eddie Wirth down the front straightaway. Kinzer in second spot. Third is Bubby Jones, followed by Mike Sweeney. In fifth spot is Jim Laurie, the fourth. He's followed by Leland McSpadden. Dean Thompson bumps into another car on the back straightaway. There was contact made with Dave Bradway Jr. Thompson keeps going, but Bradway's in trouble. Bradway is limping around the back of the race course. If he can get the car safely off, he will. Otherwise, a yellow will come out, and it looks like it will, as Bradway is unable to get his car off the racetrack. We'll be back with more exciting action from the Toyota Pacific Coast Nationals at Ascot in just a moment. You see off the track, that's the car of Dave Bradway Jr. as they bring it on the hook back into the infield of the racetrack. And Bradway very upset at a fellow driver on the racetrack. And there's a rear suspension broken on his car. Meanwhile, the car is ready to go now as they are set up for turn four. Out they come as Eddie Wirth picks up the pace. Eddie Wirth down in the front straightaway, followed by Steve Kinzer into turn number one. Bubby Jones is third. Mike Sweeney is fourth. In fifth is Jim Laurie, the fourth, followed by Leland McSpadden. And then comes Thompson. Showing the way up front, continues to be the leader of this event and tries to get away from the charge. Look at the charge down there. Bubby Jones is after Kinzer. Jones is into second spot as he passed Steve Kinzer on the outside in turn number two. McSpadden's charging. Eddie Wirth, the leader, in second spot is Bubby Jones. Steve Kinzer is third. McSpadden is trying for fourth. McSpadden runs with Sweeney. McSpadden moves into fourth spot, dropping Sweeney back to fifth. Thompson is in sixth. And we park a car. The leader is out of the race. Eddie Wirth has parked his car against the fence up in turns three and four on the outside of the racetrack. Something wrong, and Wirth, the early leader, has stalled on the track, and Bubby Jones will inherit the lead. Jones, after making that magnificent pass on the outside of turn number two as they went in, he just motored around Steve Kinzer, put the move on him, and as they got into turn number three, problems with car number 77, Eddie Wirth, the leader, and he is still in the race car. As they push him back, we'll find out if he'll be able to return to the event. Find out exactly what the problem might be. Tough luck for a man who started from the pole position and has led all but the first lap when Steve Kinzer brought him around for the first flag. And then to have problems with his car. Another one leaves the racetrack as Roger Newell in car number 78 pulls his car into the infield. Push truck bringing Eddie Wirth's car into the infield. Is he going to stop on the X, the designated work area? Yes, he is. As crew members run out to see what Eddie might need. If they can fix the car and rejoin, he could start from the back of the pack and start working his way up. But it would appear that Eddie Wirth is going to unbuckle himself from the car and climb out. Tough luck for Eddie Wirth, who was the early leader. Bubby Jones will now lead the race when they pick up the green again this time. Jones has yet to win the Pacific Coast Sprint Car Nationals. He had to sit the event out last year as he was injured the week before in a race in Phoenix. And the word from the infield is the motor let go in Eddie Wirth's car, and that's what happened, no motor. Dejectedly, they push into the infield after a magnificent run up front to lead the race early. The yellows are out again. We are expecting a green this time around as Bubby Jones will bring them out of turn number four, followed by Steve Kinzer. Away we go, and it's Jones, followed by Kinzer, then Sweeney and McSpadden. In fifth spot is Dean Thompson, followed by Jim Laurie, the fourth. Jones trying to stay away from Kitzer and get some distance between himself and second spot. Jones down the front straightaway, leading the Pacific Coast Nationals. Kitzer now starting to be challenged by the third place car of Sweeney, and right behind Sweeney comes Leland McSpadden. Kitzer's got his hands full of challengers running behind, and right behind McSpadden is Thompson. Jones, the early leader now, as we are only seven laps into the 50-lap race. Three men have led it. Kitzer led one lap, then Eddie Wirth led, and now the leader is Bubby Jones. Got a car leaving the racetrack, as car number 37, Rip Williams, who was bumped earlier in the race, takes his car into the infield. Jones still the leader. Look at the charge. Here comes Sweeney after Kitzer. Sweeney got up underneath Kitzer down at turn number two. Is he going to do it again? He's chasing him through three and four. Bubby Jones the leader. Steve Kitzer is second. Mike Sweeney is third. Fourth is Leland McSpadden. And fifth is Dean Thompson. Leland McSpadden on the move. There's Sweeney now as he rules right up behind Kitzer. Sweeney out of four, working on Kitzer down the front straightaway. Kitzer, the outlaw champion, is running in second spot. Mike Sweeney has given him all he can. The leader, Jones, out of turn number four. He's followed by Steve Kitzer, Mike Sweeney, Leland McSpadden, Dean Thompson, Jim Lorry, the fourth, and Brad Nofsinger. Jones has a quarter of a straightaway length lead over second place, Kitzer. Finishing the 12th lap of a 50-lapper, Jones with a commanding lead. Steve Kitzer is in second spot. Mike Sweeney is in third. Leland McSpadden is fourth. And knocking on the back bumper of McSpadden is Thompson as they go into turn three. Kitzer now out of turn four. Down the front chute. And there goes Thompson trying to make a move on the inside of McSpadden. McSpadden had the faster line, the outside line.